Welcome to a short video presentation on simulation of 5GNR networks in NetSim. 5GNR millimeter wave networks was introduced in NetSim from version 12 onwards. It allows for end-to-end simulation of all layers of the protocol stack as well as applications running over the network. The simulation is discrete event and done at a packet level abstraction. NetSim follows a standalone architecture and is based on 3GPP38 series. The devices specific to NetSim 5GNR library are UE, gNB, EPC, which provides end-to-end connectivity between new generation core and gNB. Buildings, users can place gNBs and UEs inside buildings to simulate indoor RF propagation effects. NetSim new radio, NR, supports two frequency bands, FR1 and FR2. We now turn to the NetSim inbuilt example, effect of UE distance on throughput in both FR1 and FR2. To open the example, go to NetSim home screen examples, 5GNR millimeter wave, distance versus throughput, FR1. This loads the saved scenario. In this example we have 1 gNB and 1 UE. The gNB is connected to EPC, which in turn connects to a server. The wired links are all 1 Gbps links. The gNB and UE are placed such that the distance between them is 100 meters initially. To access the LTENR properties, right-click on gNB and select Properties. Go to Interface LTENR Physical Layer. The carrier aggregation CA type is set to inter-band CA, and the CA count is 2. This CA configuration is set to be CA2DL1ULN39N41. Under CA1 properties, numerology is set to 2 and channel bandwidth to 40 MHz. For CA2 properties, numerology is set to 2 and channel bandwidth to 100 MHz. The millimeter wave propagation model is set as urban macro. The RF propagation channel characteristics are set to Pathloss only, LOS mode is set to user defined, with LOS probability set to 0. To model traffic, we have set a basic CBR application between wired node 3 and UE4. The transport protocol is set as UDP. The packet size remains the default 1460 bytes and the inter arrival time is set to 23 microseconds, in order to generate sufficient traffic. Next we run the simulation. From the application metrics in the results dashboard, we see that the throughput obtained in this case is 440.23 Mbps. Also from the LTENR log file, we observe the path loss, signal-to-noise ratio, downlink efficiency, CQI index, modulation scheme, CQI, and MCS code rates. Now run the sample by increasing the distance between the UE and gNB to 200, 300, 400, up to 1000 meters, and we can see the variation in throughput obtained in all the cases. Now we will run the another set of samples in frequency range FR2 and we similarly note down the readings from the LTENR log files. The FR1 and FR2 results are as shown in the following tables. One table is for FR1 and the other for FR2. From these, we can understand that as the distance increases the path loss increases, which in turn leads to lower received power and lower SNR. The lower SNR leads to a lower MCS and in turn a lower CQI, and thereby results in a lower throughput. If you compare the results of FR1 and FR2, one can notice that the drop in FR2 throughput versus distance happens at a much faster rate. This is because the path loss is much more at the higher FR2 frequencies as compared to the lower FR1 frequencies. Thank you for watching.